Good morning children, I hope all you are fine. Today I am going to conduct video for grade 9, Social Geography chapter 4, Water Resources of Karnataka. About Karnataka, we already learn about the location, extension, like longitude and latitude, then physiographic divisions, then climate, soil and natural vegetation. Now we talk about the water resources. Because every state in the present, you know, every state there is a some water reserve like a rivers, canals, wells, tanks, all are there. And because of those, the irrigation facilities provided to the farmers, and because of this, the agriculture production is going increasing. So, what kind of water resources Karnataka has, and what kind of irrigation facilities they are providing to the farmers? So, first we talk about rivers of Karnataka. We know that rivers are the main source for the irrigation, for the agriculture, or for the our domestic work water also. But we know that the rain is the source, so how to rivers also continuous flow. Some rivers like Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, those are the, they flow every year because they start from the glaciers. But the some rivers they are not able to flow all year because they depend on the rainfall only. So what about the Karnataka? Rivers are the main source of the water. We know that the rivers are, in Karnataka river there are two types of civilization. Which is the first one is the east flowing. And the second is the west flowing. Karnataka's river divided into two groups, east flowing and west flowing. It means there are two directions. In South India, there are one side Bay of Bengal and the second side Arabian Sea there. So, if those rivers, some rivers are starting from the west direction and some rivers starting from the east direction. So, for this, we first start about the east flowing river. This area, there are four famous rivers, those are the start from the here. Which is the Krishna, second is the Kaveri, third is the Godavari, and the fourth is the Mahanadi. These four famous rivers, and along there are more tributaries of this river. Okay. So first we talk about the Krishna. The Krishna is the second important river of South India and it is the start from the Mahabaleshwar. And its length is 1,392 kilometers. It is the second important river. So which is the first important river of Karnataka? Kaveri river. So about Krishna river, it is 1,392 kilometers and it is joined in the Bay of Bengal, but in Karnataka only it flows 488. The total length of this river is 1,390 kilometers, but in Karnataka only flow 480 kilometers. Other in areas is in other states. After that, those are the tributaries of this river, which is Bhima, Koina, Tungbhadra, Ghatprabha, Malaprabha. Those are the this river's tributaries. And because of this river, there are dam facilities also there, and they are providing the hydroelectric power generation also. And because of this river, northern Karnataka, they just found a more benefits. Now we talk about the first important river of Karnataka, which is the Kaveri river. It is also known as the Dakshin Ganga. In North India, Ganga river is there, and the same kind of importance in the South India, Kaveri. So that's why it is the rename they gave the Dakshin Ganga. It is originated from the Tala Kaveri, which is in a Kodagu district, and its flow 804 km in Karnataka. It flows 804 km in Karnataka and in Tamil Nadu also. After it's there are also many tributaries, which is a Hemavati, Lokapavani, Arakavati, Shimsha, Kapila, Suvarnavati and Bhavani. Those are the tributaries river, and this river is the most useful for the agriculture, power generation and drinking water supply. In the, if we talk about the Bangalore only, the mostly the all the water supply which is for the, we are using for the our domestic work, our water drinking work purpose, or there are household purpose, these are supplied by the Kaveri River only. Now the next river which is important, which is the Penna, Palar and the Godavari and Mahanadi river, those are also flow in the Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, all these areas. Next we talk about the west flowing river. In the west flowing river, it is started, most of the river starting from the Malnad region, and after that they join the Arabian Sea. So some example of west flowing rivers are Sharavati river, Kali, Gangavali, Netravati, Varahi and Agravanshi rivers. In that, those water in these rivers, there are some steep slopes are there and the large waterfalls is there, which is the major waterfall in this river, the Sharavati river, Jokha, which is the India's largest waterfall are there. And those rivers is also important for hydroelectric power stations. Some important waterfalls of according to those rivers is the Gokha on a Ghat Prabha, Banja on Netravati, Unchali on Agnashini, then Chaya Bhagavati on a Don River, and etc. Next we talk about irrigation in Karnataka. Because the river, we know that for agriculture we need water. Without water we can't do the agriculture thing. And in India, only 3 or 4 months the rain is there. Other all the months there are the summer season or the winter season. So it means we need irrigation facility for agriculture. And the 50% of population depend on agriculture in the present time also, because we need it for our development. So we know that what is the agriculture, what is the irrigation? The artificial water supply, it is called irrigation. And it is started from the before independence also to try to develop the more agriculture production. It is recently known for the some benefits, like it is provided by the wells, canals, tank and maybe other resources. So irrigation provided by all these resources. In the present time, in there are all know that the main source of irrigation of the wells, canals and tanks. But in early days, the people are just depend according to well system only. They just dug well in the farm, in the field only, in the agriculture field only. And after they start to just joining the well pump, and because of the pump, the forcing of the motor, they just try to do. In the present time, there are more facilities providing to the government, and there are some new system is also there for irrigation, like a drop sink system and all the different system. Okay, for example, Shanti Sagar in Devangiri district, the well dug in Kalaburagi district during the 11th century, the Tungbhadra canal of the time of Vijayanagar Empire, Vani Vila Sagar and the Krishna Raj Sagar dam constructed by the Mysore kings are the milestone in the development of the irrigation facility. In the present time, both river water and underground water are used for irrigation. Nearly 26.2% of the cultivable land is under irrigation facility in Karnataka, and Karnataka has occupied the 9th position for India in with the regard to irrigation. Now the Raichur district has the largest area under the canal irrigation. The tank irrigation, Shimoga district and the Belagavi district have a well irrigation facility, the largest this type of irrigation. If we talk about that the land under irrigation facilities, then taken into consideration, then Belagavi district occupied the first position and the Kodagu district occupies the last position in this irrigation facility. Now the main canal irrigation facilities, which is provided by Krishna Sagar Dam, Tungabhadra, those rivers. According to rivers, there are dam is there, and according to them, they are providing the canal facilities, which is are the many more. Now we talk about the hydroelectric power. Hydroelectric power is also with the help of the dam. When they build any dam for on a river, then with the high speed the water is flowing, then it is that just tried with the some machines, engineers, and according to this they try to make electric power. So the credit of a successful generation of a hydroelectric power for the first time in India goes to Karnataka. Start the first hydroelectric power project. So if the credit goes to Karnataka state for the improvising this method. Coal and petroleum are not available in our state. We know that because the coal is normally there in Maharashtra and the Chhattisgarh and Raipur and those areas we found. But the petroleum we found in a Bombay high area, which is not in a near the Karnataka. So according to this, we have only this facility, which is a hydroelectric power facility. So there are rivers which can be provide sufficient power for the whole state. Rivers flowing through towards the west and most suitable for the generation from then the river flowing through the east. Then the hydroelectric power station at Shiv Samudra was established in 1902. First one is established in 1902, which is on a Shiv Samudra river, and the supply to the whatever electric power they produce, they first supply to the Kolar gold mines. So from 1902 they started and they're providing electricity to the Kolar gold mine, because in the industry they need more power supply. After that, the project was constructed on a river Kaveri, and it is short distance away. It is a second hydro power station was established on a Shimsha river in 1940. The second project is came in 1940. So it means increasing a lot of things about those projects. After that, the third project start, which is a Mahatma Gandhi hydroelectric power station, established in 1947 near Jog Falls on a Shalavati river. So is there like this, they just try to develop more program, and after that the government of the central government, they gave the 5 years plan. In the 5 years plan, every year they try to give the at least one or two hydro electricity power project for the states. So according to this, that this type of projects are increasing day by day. Okay, so there are some important hydro electric power projects of Karnataka, which is I am telling the name: Shiv Samudra, Shimsha, which is on a Kaveri river, then Sharavati, Linganamakki, and Geru Sopa and Mahatma Gandhi hydro power station, which is on a Sharavati river, then Supa, Nagarjari, Kadra, and Kodisali, which is on a Kali river, then Varahi and Mari Kanive, which is on a Varahi river. And the last one is the Bhadra, Tungbhadra, Ghat Prabha, and Alamati, which is on a Krishan. Those are the important hydroelectric power project of Karnataka. Now the last topic is the river water disputes. We know that the rivers are there. It is not a deadline for the any river. The deadline is when it flows, when it joins the maybe Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, or the India. That is the only deadline for those rivers. But the they just start from the one stage and enter in a second stage. There is a no deadline, there is a no restriction for them, because it is a natural. But for this also there are some times the state start dispute, the state start problems, that why this river flow in our state of 400 kilometer and in the next state only 3, so why we are getting a less water and those getting a more water. Or maybe because of the built dam in a one state and the second state, because of them there is just supply they are not able to get, or some kind of reason. So according to those reasons, they start disputing, they start to conflict between each other states. And this kind of issues are especially seen for the South India for the two rivers, which is a Krishna and a Kaveri. There are disputes between the first is the Krishna River, which is a Karnataka and the Tamil Nadu and Kerala. And for the Kaveri River is also Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Puducherry. I mean all states are trying to capture more water capacity from that particular river. But it is not possible, because time by time they are just try to resolve this, and this matter is just again for state matters is going in a Supreme Court, and the issues and the people also try to hurt each other, states people and all this thing. So this is not a way to fight for a river water, because river is a natural resource. So some main important, which is every time we saw there is a Krishna and Kaveri river issues is also there, but the government tried to resolve. So this is your chapter. In that chapter we saw, we learned that about Karnataka's river, which is a two types of groups divided, east flowing and west flowing. In the east flowing there are main important rivers, the Krishna, Kaveri, Pennar and Palar, and in west flowing there are Sharavati and the Tungbhadra and all the etc. rivers. After that, irrigation facility, because without irrigation, agriculture production is not going increasing. We need it, because in India, the rainfall is, in Karnataka, it is good, but it is not a sufficient for all the time, for the whole year. After that, there are hydroelectric power project. Because of rivers, we know that there are more electricity and more dams we have already built on those. So with the help of all these things, we try to produce the electricity. This is a new technique and it is a natural also. Then the last one is a river water disputes. So today I am going to end my session. Thank you.